Hi, welcome to another episode of Gear Up with Gregg's. I'm Dan, and I'll be your host today as we go over Baldor, electric, and pedestal grinders. Baldor was formed in St. Louis in 1920 and is now located in Fort Smith, Arkansas. It was founded by Emile Dore and Edwin Ballman. As you can tell, they were very original when they created their name. Ball? Dore? Get it? You know. Okay, before we get into the grinders and how they work, let's take a look at some definitions. Grind. To shape, sharpen, or refine something with friction. Abrasive, a substance or material used for cleaning, grinding, smoothing, or polishing. RPM, revolutions per minute, is a measure of the frequency of rotation, specifically the number of rotations around a fixed axis in 1 minute. Grit, measure of the fineness of the abrasive material such as those used in polishing compounds and sandpapers. Originally, it was expressed as the number of holes per square inch of the mesh used in screening a particular material. Since the development of extremely fine abrasives, it denotes the average particle size of the material in micrometers. Single phase power, used in most homes in North America. Able to supply ample power for most smaller customers, including homes and small non-industrial businesses. Three-phase power. Common in large businesses, as well as industry and manufacturing. Highly efficient for equipment designed to run on three-phase power. To illustrate the difference between single-phase and three-phase power, imagine a lone paddler in a canoe. He can only move himself forward while his paddle is in the water. When he removes his paddle from the water to prepare for the next stroke, the power supplied to the canoe is zero. Now picture the same canoe with three paddlers. If the strokes are synchronized, so there's always one paddle in the water, the canoe will move across the water in a more smooth and efficient manner. The two grinders we'll go over today are the big red grinder and the industrial grinder. First, why would somebody be interested in one of these great grinders? Well, to start, Baldor's grinders are definitely industrial and can withstand day-to-day use in heavy industrial environments. With a cast housing, rubber feet to reduce vibrations, and meeting all OSHA standards, they're built for heavy grinding. A wise man once said, "The bench grinder is to the shop as the trainer is to the team, but it won't ice any ankle injuries." Get it? No? All right then. Grinders work by driving abrasive wheels. Depending on the types of wheel, it may be used in a fine application to sharpen cutting tools or drill bits. Or alternatively, it can be used to roughly shape metal prior to welding or fitting. A wire brush wheel or a buffing wheel can be interchanged to clean or polish. Something to keep in mind, here at Gregg's, we have a variety of brands for you to choose from as far as grinding and replacement wire wheels are concerned. So how do we decide which grinder is right for you? First, we need to know what size wheel you're looking for. 6, 7, 8, and 10 inch are available. What's your power supply like? The Big Red grinder is single phase. The industrial grinder is three phase. Next, what comes with your new grinder? If you go with a Big Red, you get a 36 grit aluminum oxide wheel and a wire brush. If you go with the larger industrial grinder, you get two aluminum oxide abrasive wheels in 36 and 60 grit. And you get two eye shields that come with both models. What else do you need to get going? How about a place to mount it? You can secure either of the two bench grinders to a bench or one of these two pedestals to free up space. In case you were wondering, we also carry direct replacement switches and eye shields in the Baldor brand. We also have replacement grinder wheels, wire wheels, and wheel dressers, and all appropriate PPE necessary to operate these grinders. Safety is always important, especially when using heavy-duty equipment like a Baldor industrial grinder. To make sure you have a safe and secure work environment, the following should be done. Make sure the grinder is securely fastened to the bench or pedestal, as well as making sure all guards are in place. Check wheels, tighten nuts, and manually spin the wheel before turning on. Remember, Big Red spins at 3600 RPM, and the industrial grinder is 1500 to 1800 RPM. As I was saying, safety is very important when working with an industrial grinder. Proper PPE for an industrial grinder would be eye, hearing, face protection, and safety boots. Respiratory protection, depending on the type of work, and gloves, only when there is no risk of entanglement. Well, that's it for today with Baldor Electric. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact one of our sales reps, such as myself, and we'd be happy to answer any of your questions. Thanks for continuing to support a 100% Canadian company, and thanks for watching Gear Up with Gregg's today.